I want to start off by recognizing the significance of today. Over 50 years ago, our mothers and grandmothers won this fight for us. They didn't win it completely, but they brought it a long way. And over the last 50 years, those wins have been chipped away at, and chipped away at, and chipped away at, until just a year ago, those rights were in an instant taken away. And now we live in a state where it's easy to forget when we've had successes like winning a one-seat majority in the House of Representatives, but let's not forget what compelled the voters of Pennsylvania to get us there. Late at night, at the end of the budget process in 2022, the Republican Senate here in this body, in this building, brought a bill before the chamber that would eliminate any right to an abortion in Pennsylvania. And the voters of Pennsylvania sent 102, one vote, one seat, that is actually on the ballot again for what, the fourth or fifth time since we started this session. And the voters of Pennsylvania have continued to give us that one seat that stands between a constitutional ban on abortion in Pennsylvania if Republicans regain control of this building. And as a mother of an eight-year-old girl who has a mother and a grandmother who 50 years ago thought that this fight was won, it's time for us to finish the job for our kids so that we never find ourselves in this position again. I had a personal experience today. It was with getting a passport, but it just reminds you of all the other things that women, when restrictive laws like the laws that created with requirements for hallways for a woman to receive abortion care, the roadblocks that get put in front of women that don't exist for men. I changed my name since the last time I got a passport. I've now had to go three times to just simply renew my passport and to get passports for my children. And that exists in so many different ways for women to just do the regular things that women need to do, whether it's getting a credit card, getting your cell phone transferred from one provider to the next. The roadblocks that stand in the way of women costing us time, energy, money, hoping that we'll just give up, right? And this bill is no different. It creates excessive requirements for women to receive essential care in the hopes that we'll just give up, in the hopes that we just won't want to put in the effort because it's not worth it. It's critically important that this legislature do everything it can to remove every roadblock that has been put in place over all of time, but especially over the last 50 years, to stand in the way of women receiving essential health care. Because what do these restrictive laws mean? They don't mean less abortions. They mean more unsafe procedures. They mean more women putting their lives at risk, or the government putting women's lives at risk. They mean headlines like we've seen in Ohio and Texas, where women are dying of sepsis because they're waiting for the government to allow them to receive the essential care that they need, they desire, and that their doctors recommend. Excessive restrictions on women's health care means less women's health care. It doesn't mean less abortions. It means less safe health care for women and girls in this Commonwealth. And so I'm proud to stand with my colleagues here today. I'm proud to stand with Planned Parenthood in working toward removing the obstacles that make life, living, thriving, succeeding in Pennsylvania more difficult for women. Thank you.